does that saying go? It's always something. In my design life, it's not always something. It's always analog. Okay, maybe not always, but it is pretty close. Maybe you're like me and you're not part of that 0.1% of engineers out there who can call themselves analog experts. But if you are, shoot me an email because I've got some questions for you. Okay, I know I'm not the only one that has trouble with the analog bits and bobs. And boy, simulating all of that stuff before it gets all the way down the road to the lab bench, troubleshooting land, would be very much appreciated. Hi, I'm Amelia Dalton, host of Chalk Talk. Yes, I can count on one hand the number of analog gurus I know. And I know a lot of engineers. But what if we could all be analog experts? Or at least head off a lot of those downstream analog problems? Yeah, that'd be helpful, right? Today, my guest is Rico Brooks from Microchip, and he promised me that he's going to help me with all of this. Yep, in this episode of Chalk Talk, Rico and I are talking all about Microchip's MPLAB Mindi, what this powerful electrical simulation tool can do, and how MPLAB Mindi can help reduce design risk, thereby saving us yet another analog-induced headache. All right, let's go. And before we get started, don't forget to click that link. There you can find even more information about Microchip's MPLAB Mindi. Hi, Rico. Thank you so much for joining me.
Thank you for having me.
Okay, so we are here today to talk about MPLAB Mindi. But Rico, what exactly is this Mindi?
So MPLAB Mindi is an integrated, fast, powerful tool that allows you to do a lot of analog simulations, so signal chain simulations, and also power management simulations. It also saves you time to market and allows you to do what-if scenarios, all your corner cases as well, to find bugs in your design before you go into hardware or before your design gets out in the field to your customers.
Okay, great. So Rico, simulation in the analog world can be tricky business, right?
Correct. So what Mindi actually provides the end user is an easy way to simulate their power management signal chain design. So the simulation interface is very easy to use. We have our proprietary Microchip models of all of our analog devices in our tool, and we provide two tools in one to provide your simulation. So we have our Symmetrics and also our Simplest tool. The Symmetrics environment covers our mixed signal side, which covers our active filters, our INAs, and our op amps as well, and comparators. The Simplest side covers our power management devices. So mainly our motor drivers, power modules and controllers, and our DEPA products as well. So the other thing to keep in mind about the Mindi tool is we have over 160 individual application schematics, and it's constantly growing. We update our tool every quarter. And another benefit of the tool is that we can simulate up to 140 nodes of circuitry. A lot of programs or simulation tools will count the nodes of the model as you bring it in and will actually take away from that budget. But our models do not affect that budget. So you have 140 extra nodes worth of circuitry to simulate within our models. So local installation, you do not need an internet connection. It is a free tool. It's also compatible with the commercial version of Symmetrics and Simplest, but the difference is ours converges up to 50 times faster.
Wow. Okay. So Rico, what does this Mindi really buy me as an engineer?
So it'll allow the engineer to test ideas, any changes, also any trade-offs or corner cases in simulation prior to creating any hardware. So a lot of the problems that can be found in simulation, it'll save them time, also any effort from the hardware fixes. It'll also save on field returns. The last thing an engineer wants is for their customer to find bugs that they could have found or should have found in their simulation.
Absolutely. So can my digital friends use this as well, or is this just for the analog guys?
Well, we're targeting the hobbyist as well as the sophisticated user. These are engineers with strong analog backgrounds, whether it's in the signal chain or also power management.
Okay, so let's dive in a little deeper and talk about the simulator itself. Now, Rico, what all does it include?
The Mindi Analog Simulator includes two tools in one. So it has a Symmetrics tool and a Simplest tool. The Symmetrics tool covers our analog and mixed signal products. So mainly, as I discussed earlier, our analog filters, our instrumentation amplifiers, our zero drift amplifiers as well. But it also will allow you to do sweep mode analysis, Fourier analysis, transmission lines, fast Monte Carlo analysis, safe operating area. And it's very flexible in importing third-party external SPICE models as well. And on the other side, the simplest side, that covers the power management side. This is mainly for the power engineers. This is going to cover not just your buck or boost converters. It's also going to cover your motor drives, as well our LED drivers, our LDO regulators, and also our MOSFET drivers. So the other benefit to the tool is it provides good convergence, whether it's the simplest side or the symmetric side. As discussed earlier, our tool converges up to 50 times faster than the commercial version. This allows the engineer to simulate their models much faster and evaluate their results much faster as well. Also provides steady state operating point for periodic switching systems, fast and reliable time domain transient analysis. You can do multi-step analysis as well. You can also do efficiency calculations, which is very important to the power engineer. You can also do phase and gain simulations as well.
Okay, so Rico, can you walk me through how this works?
Absolutely. So here you see is the main landing page or welcome page and navigation tree for the Mindi analog simulation tool. What we're showing here is where you can actually dig into find our models. Anything that we've added new to the tool allows you to create new schematics and symmetrics or simplest. All your MPLAB Mindi support material, whether it's for symmetrics or simplest, and any tutorials as well. It'll also show you any of the recent schematics that you've used. So here's a snapshot of our model categories and schematics. You can see here, we have them expanded here. So you can see our high voltage interface, our linear amplifiers, MOSFET drivers, our power management, and as well as our power over Ethernet devices. All are available to simulate inside the MPLAB Mindi tool. We also provide additional pop-up information. What this provides to the engineer as they're looking at each model category is just a short summary of, say, what an active filter is, what a MOSFET driver is, what the switching regulator is, so what that particular part number or category represents. We also have built-in design analyzers. So once you find the part number you want to simulate, you'll see a box that says design analyzer. This allows the engineer to do some preliminary simulations before going into full SPICE mode. So you can see here in this schematic, you can change your input voltage, your output voltage. You can also change your compensation. You can change your passives as well, all the parasitics. And then you can simulate this design and look at your Bode plot, your phase and gain margin, your crossover frequency, your efficiency curve to see exactly how it's going to perform. And if you're happy with those values that you've chosen, then you would choose load schematic. It would automatically change the SPICE model schematic to those values, including all the parasitics that you've changed as well. And then you can start analyzing based on those values.
Okay, so what's the cost here? Is this a special permission from my boss kind of thing?
No, it's an absolutely free tool. So you just click the link here, download, and start using the tool. You do not have to be online to use it as well. It's an offline tool. And we update the tool about every other quarter with new models.
Excellent. Okay. So what if I need help with power management? Maybe a motor driver or a power module. Does Mindi support different devices as well?
Absolutely. So in our models, the available models that we have today, specifically in power management, we have MOSFET and motor drivers, but we'll also provide PWM controllers, power modules, LED drivers, and switching regulators. So it covers all of your power management needs, as well as your mixed signal needs to.
Okay, this sounds great, but Rico, how about some real numbers? What does this simulation look like compared to actual results?
So here's an example of output voltage ripple, our simulation versus experimental results. So in the simulation results on the left-hand side, we have a result of 10.2, or measurement of 10.2 millivolts peak to peak. And on the right-hand side, our experimental measurement in the lab was 9.4 millivolts peak to peak. So very, very little deviation between the two results. And then here's another example of low transient response. On the left, a waveform shows a peak to peak voltage of 6.5 millivolts. On the right, our experimental lab results shows 15 millivolts. And then another example, loop gain frequency response. You can see our simulation and experimental results are almost on top of each other throughout the entire frequency response. One thing to keep in mind to improve your simulation results is to include proper component derating and parasitic values.
All right, Rico, this has been a bit to cover today. So can you recap your main points for me?
Yes. So some of the key points to remember is the MPLAB Mindi analog simulation tool improves circuit designs and reduces design risk by allowing the designer to simulate analog and power circuits prior to hardware prototyping. It is also fully compatible with the standard Symmetrics and Simplest tool and converges up to 50 times faster. And MPLAB Mindi is also free of charge and will be continuously maintained and expanded.
Okay, Rico. Well, I think that's all I have time for today. Thank you so much for joining me.
Thank you for having me.
And before we go, you didn't forget to click that link, did you? There you can find even more information about MPLAB Mindi from Microchip. For Chalk Talks, I'm Amelia Dalton from eejournal.com. For more Chalk Talks, head on over to the Chalk Talk section of EE Journal. You can't miss it. It's right across the top. Or head on over to YouTube, youtube.com/eejournal.